Philosophical theology is a way of understanding God in merely rational manner. We consider philosophical theology as a crucial part of metaphysics. This definition brings the questions, in what sense can philosophical theology be orthodox? The question is sound because there is no orthodox rationality. There is only universal rationality. Therefore, philosophical theology seems to be entirely unreligious. We can answer this question keeping in mind double nature of the beginning of any branch of philosophy. To begin a philosophy is to do two things. First, we shall formulate the most fundamental questions and give answers to them as if, only as if, no one had answered the questions before us. So to say, we shall give new answers to everlasting questions. Second thing, on the other hand, we as a philosopher, theologian, are always in a historical context. We are always within a framework of a tradition. So we have to communicate with the tradition to fit our concept, to fit our answers to the fundamental questions into that framework, into that tradition. These two points describe just a general framework of starting philosophy, starting of philosophical theology as well. That framework embodies differently in each particular cases, but it is still remain the same structure. The second point on that framework is a way for philosophical theology to be specifically orthodox and not some abstract theology. So we do develop philosophical theology using rational philosophical tools, but we do it in the context of orthodox tradition as a part of our general context for our work. Another part is a philosophy as a tradition itself. There are two major philosophical traditions, analytics and continentals. And I just have a short references because Professor Swinburne described that tradition quite completely. Analytic philosophy has spread to Anglophone countries. This kind of philosophy is very sensitive to the latest scientific achievements and comes to conclusions by strict argument. Analytic philosophy doesn't pay much attention to its history. It's an important point for me because it doesn't mean that in analytic tradition we don't have historical attitude, historical approach, but it just don't so important to that tradition. Quite the contrary, continental philosophy has a basis in philosophical texts by post-Kantian philosophers, as already mentioned, Nietzsche, Heidegger, and others. History of philosophy is essential to philosophize in this tradition. Despite all that 20th century critique of metaphysics and theology, today both of them have undergone something of a renaissance. Theological turn in French phenomenology is a bright example of that movement. Both of these traditions have done a great work during the last century. We should not ignore any of them, but we have to choose a starting point in developing philosophical theology. So our prime communicator in that context is continental philosophy because of its emphasis on historicity. That's quite important for our understanding of aim of philosophical theology. We encourage our scholars, and that is the most general challenge we acknowledge. We encourage our scholars to bring to discuss challenges specific to an Orthodox community at any particular context. For example, in Russian Orthodox Church, I regularly meet a misbelief, such as this one. There is no need to develop theology because Holy Fathers had already said everything you need. It's quite common. I'm not sure if we have a similar situation at other denomination, other Orthodox churches, but in Russian church, I hear it quite a lot. I suppose all of us can agree that we have no chance to repeat others, just to read, understand, and that's all. But there is no way to, so to say, treat this way that great tradition. But we can develop theology in communication with others. That is possible. Just in this way, I understand the motto, Florovsky motto, back to the fathers. It's not literally leave your speculation and just read, but communicate with that great predecessors. We will overcome that misbelief if we, that mean, talking we, I mean our groups in working together, to find a way to explain it to the community. About points of collaboration, it's an open list, I remind you, in signed Yoda. What the most obvious, we have to collaborate with philosophy of religion group because we share the most fundamental topics, argument for the existence of God, argument against the existence of God, and so on. It was already mentioned quite clear. We can collaborate with dogmatic theology, moral theology, for the quite similar reason, because we share some fundamental questions. Working with patristic group and religion and science group, very fruitful for us because the second point of a framework when I talk about communicating, working with previous tradition is crucial point, that group will be most helpful. Outside IOTA, we mean to collaborate with scholars in fields like history of philosophy, not necessarily interested previously in Orthodox theology, with scholars from history of idea and philosophy of science.